Hi, Ed Friedland, the Bass Whisperer, here once again for Guitar World magazine. This month we're looking at two new amps from Fender, the TV-15 and TV-10 combo amps. The Fender TV series are vintage-style combo amps with old-school tone and a modern approach. Under the hood, we've got Class D switching power amps,
Celestion Green Label drivers,
which keep the overall package very lightweight. On the front end, we've got a tube preamp driving the legendary Fender tone stack. The TV-10 and 12 are 150-watt combos, while the 15 and 210 combos are 350-watt amplifiers.
The combos are all rear-ported and have a balanced XLR line out with ground lift. There's also a cooling fan included. There are two inputs. Input 2 has a minus 6 dB pad for active instruments. The glowing red jewel light is classic Fender, as is the 50s style logo badge.
Now, the Fender tone stack is a passive and very interactive circuit. It's not like modern amplifiers where each tone knob kind of has a specific frequency range and it affects it individually. They work together. On the old original Fender tone stacks, flat was considered 0 on the bass control, 10 on the mid control, and 0 on the treble control. So in effect, the bass and treble controls acted as boost only, and the mid control effectively acted as cut only. Well, on the new TV series, essentially it all works the same. They've made one minor change, and flat is now bass and treble on 2 and the mid range on 10. So here's the flat tone. Of course, no amplifier is truly flat, but this is what they consider the flat signal on the amp. The bass is up full, everything's wide open. Okay, now I'm going to boost some low end. I'm on 2. You can hear that it rounds it out quite nicely. I've got the bass up on 10. Remember, these controls go to 12. Beefs it up real nicely. And then we've got the treble control. I'm going to roll it up. Now remember, there are no tweeters in these amps, so the treble, you're not going to hear it like that sizzly hi-fi type of thing you hear on a modern amp. It's definitely a more vintage contour. Now, if we roll some mids back, you can hear how the center kind of comes out of the tone. We'll roll some treble off. Get a fatter, warmer tone. On the TV 12, 15, and 210 models, there are also deep and bright switches to help beef the tone up a little bit. Here's flat. Now I'm going to put the deep switch on. Now here's flat again. Now here's the bright switch. Here's both. Another feature that the TV-12, 15, and 210 share is a gain control in addition to the volume control. So that means you can hit that tube a little bit harder and get some nice warm breakup. Now right now I've got the amp set with the master on full and the tube gain at about 4. Here's the sound with the tube gain all the way up and the master down. The distortion is real pleasing, and of course with a passive instrument like this, you know, you're not going to hit the input quite hard enough to get some serious breakup. But with a preamp instrument, you can really hit that tube and make it sing. Well, the styling and the tone go all the way back to the 50s, so let's try my 51 reissue now. Well, it's no surprise that the TV-15 sounds great with a passive 4-string, but it also handles active 5-string just as well. Handles the low B quite well. Let's take a look at the TV-10 now. It's a 150-watt combo with a single 10. Isn't it cute? I'll call him Mini-Me. The TV-10 is the only amp in the series that doesn't have a gain control or deep and bright switches, but it's still capable of some pretty good volume. The tone stack is set flat right now. Here's the volume on 3. I'm going to bring it up to about 7. Bring some more bass in. Hope you've enjoyed this look at the Fender TV Combo series. They're great looking amps. They sound terrific. Excuse me, I'm going to see what's on TV. Thank you.